Alright, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all honor, praises, and glory to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone, the Rule Well, and blessings to the hopeful elect out there pushing this word in all sincerity and in truth. This lesson, I'm just going to go into the name of the Lord, man, and I'm going to kick it off with this scripture over here in Psalms, chapter 34, verse 3. It says, "Oh, magnify the Lord Yahweh with me. And let us exalt his name together." And that's what we do, man. You know, predominantly when we go out there on the highways and the byways, you know, when you're with your fellow laborers, man, your brothers to your left and your brothers to your right, man, and you're throwing up the name of the Lord. You know, every time we kick up camp, we go out there, we present our bodies as living sacrifices, pulling down Esau's stronghold bit by bit. Every time we throw up the name, this kingdom, his kingdom is crumbling, man. That's why we have a duty, man. We have a duty and an unction to go out there and teach this word, man, and fuck up this so-called white man society. Because the more we push the name and the vibration out there, is the faster that this kingdom is going down, and the elect men will be sealed, man, and we can get the fuck up out of here, man. All right, and we're supposed to exalt the name of the Lord together, man. All right, as one body, man, the same doctrine in unity, man, and that's what this is all about: magnifying the name of the Lord. All right, with your elect, with your fellow elect. Future governing body over Israel, man, or the future governing body over Israel. All right, your elect brothers, man, and that's what it's all about, and it's a beautiful thing to do that. So let me go to Romans 12, because this is the duty that we have to do as going out there on the highways and the byways, man. As it says in Proverbs 1 and 22, I believe, "Wisdom crieth without; she uttereth her voice in the streets." We go out there, we are the voice of wisdom out in the streets, man, including the name of the Lord. Most importantly. Okay, Romans 12 and 1, "I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of the Most High, that ye present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto the Most High, which is your reasonable service." This is our reasonable service, all right? It doesn't matter how many videos you do, how many precepts you think you know, man. All right. At the end of the day, it's your reasonable service to go out there and teach this word. It's not for your own vainglory, man, to fill your own belly. It's to magnify the name of the Lord, all right? That's why the Lord took down the Egyptians. That's why the Lord has always been jacked up Sodom and Gomorrah, so that everyone must fear his name, man. All right? Mainly the children of Israel, but all these other nations, they used to call him Al-Shadya, man. Now they don't even know. All right? Now they don't even know what's going on. You know, they got their own gods. They're worshipping Allah and all of this bullshit. Really, there's going to come a time, man, when Yahweh Shai cracks them clouds, there ain't going to be no gray areas, man. They're going to know. That's why the scripture says, "Surely thou art a power that hideth thyself," man. When they see the Lord, the Lord said he's going to come with his clouds and his chariots like a whirlwind, man. All right? Behold, Revelation 1 and 7 says, "Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see it, man." And in that day, believe you me, they're going to know the name of the Lord, man. And they're going to know that the prophets that were out there, then shall they know that a prophet have been among them, man. Okay? But I'm going to take it back a little bit, man, because you had them wicked scribes and Pharisees. So let's go into the book of Acts, because the importance of the name and the vibration of that name, or what it was doing back there in the ancient times, man. All right, when you had the disciples going out there teaching the name of the Lord, all right, they were so worried. The wicked scribes and Pharisees, they were so worried about getting their positions run up on because they were going out there teaching in the name of the Lord. Look at what they did to Yahweh Shai, man. In fact, they were so worried about their positions, they crucified him, man. They said, "Kill him, let his blood be upon us. We have no king but Caesar, man. Upon us and our children." Okay, so this is Acts 4 from the top. "And as they spake unto the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came upon them." All right. "But being grieved that they taught the people." So they were grieved that they taught the people. Just like how they're grieved that we're teaching the people now, man. How many times you guys out there, you know, you brothers worldwide come up to your, you get scoffers and scorners coming up to your camps, which is also prophecy. All right. Peter, it says that in the book of Peter's, "There shall come in the last days scoffers," man. All right. And that's what you get when you go out there on the highways and the byways, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, man. All right. It's in a reasonable service. It's a reasonable thing. And the Lord said, after you've done all of these things, man, no matter how much precepts you've read out, man, how many times you've read for a brother, how many times you spoke out there, the Lord says, still say I'm an unprofitable servant, man, because this is our reasonable service, to glorify the name of the Lord. That's why he created us. That's why he put his name upon the children of Israel, man, just to magnify and glorify his name. Put respect on his name. We are banners for Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Okay? It says, "But being grieved," so they were pissed, man. Alright, they were like, "Ah! He's gonna take away our place, man. Oh fuck! They can't teach the people this, right? And preach through Yahweh Shai the resurrection from the dead. So because they were preaching of Yahweh Shai, because they were so fucked up with Yahweh Shai that they crucified him, man. All right, the scripture says his visions were so marred more than any man. All right, there was no Emmett Till can't even compare to what they did to Yahweh Shai, man. And you saw the pictures of Emmett Till, man. Okay, that shows the level of hatred. And if the spirit of Yahweh Shai is in us brothers out there on the highways and the byways, just know that the whole world's coming against us, man. Those that are not of the elect. Okay, but the Lord said, "Blessed are the when men shall revile you, man, and persecute you, and separate you from their company." This is our reasonable service, man. You should know what you signed up for, man. Okay, it says verse 3, and they laid hands on them and put them in hold until the next day, for it was now eventide. Yeah, they imprisoned them, man. How many times did the disciples get imprisoned, man, the apostles, man? They got imprisoned, man, and countless amounts of times the Lord delivered them from that. The Lord said he ain't going to tempt you above your measure, man. All right, the Lord delivered them from their captivities, man, from these evil, wicked fucking scribes and Pharisees that were grabbing and laying their hands on them, man, for teaching the name of the Lord, for teaching the doctrine of Yahweh Shai, man, the volume of the book. Okay, it says, howbeit, many of them which heard the word believed, and a number of the men was about 5,000. All right, so that's a beautiful thing, and we're coming to the times now, man, where you might be teaching that, you might see a little crowd of brothers, you know, on the other side, listening, you know, taking, getting their highlighters out, taking their notes down. But it's going to come a time when something's going to happen, man, whether it be an act or a miracle or whatever, man. And before you know it, just like in the times of the apostles, man, 3,000 were added to the church, man. Just like when, I believe, was it Peter that healed the lame man at the Temple Beautiful, man? And he was lame from birth, couldn't even walk. And then the next day, 3,000 souls were added to the church. I believe it was 3,000. Man, you could have just a small act of a miracle happen, and then bang. Them small handful of brothers that you were teaching now turns into 3,000, man. What are you going to say about that? Are you ready for that, man? This is what I'm saying, man. We are in some, look, man, we're in some times right now. And recently, you just had a video of us brothers over here in London that just took the internet by a storm, man. And the Lord did that. The Lord was with that, all right? Because one of them guys from Speaker's Corner over here in London re-uploaded one of the videos, and now it's just got over 300,000 hits. Just like that, man. All right, but the Lord said man's goings are of the Lord. How then can a man understand his own way? So the Lord orchestrated that. He sealed the instruction for whoever to re-upload that video for it to take the world by a storm, man. Or to take the UK by a storm, should I say, man. You even had a guy, what's his name? Tariq, some smooth butter-looking nigger. Big butt looking shiny ass nigger talking shit against us, saying that we should have rolled up on them Irish guys, man, that came up chatting shit at the camp. But we ain't carnal, man. All right, Captain already done put it on that guy, man. So you know we don't even have to talk about that. Let's stick to the point. Acts, I'm gonna jump to Acts 5:28, and I'm gonna start from 27. And when they had brought them, they set them before the council, and the high priest asked them, saying, "Did we not straightly command you that you should not teach in this name? And behold, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us." So they hate the doctrine, man. And if they hated Yahweh Shai, they persecuted the master of the household, how much more his servants, man? All right, but we don't fear you guys, man. We fear Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. In fact, that's there's another one, Malachi 4:2. Let me just grab that real quick, man, because we fear the name of the Lord, man. All right, knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, do we persuade men? And we were persuaded through the terror of the Lord, man. That's why we do what we do, okay? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. We ain't too proud to admit that we fear the Lord. Fuck you, man. All right, Malachi 4:2. But unto you that fear my name, shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go forth and grow up as the calves of the stool. So yeah, unto those that fear the name of the Lord, meaning the elect, are going to fear the name of the Lord, man. All right? So the Son of Man arise with healing in his wings. And that's when Yahweh Shai is going to come and change us from these vile bodies, man. And we're going to get them spiritual bodies, man. That's that healing, man. Okay? And the Lord has already started the healing process. The spirit of Yahweh Shai is already working with us, man. That's why we turn from all of our wicked ways, man. They that are holy, not a physician, but they that are sick, man. All right? And we were sick out there in the world, doing all kinds of manners of heinous acts, should I say now. Now we've been healed by the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. And it's a beautiful thing. And why should we not glorify the name of the Lord for taking us all out of all of this madness, man? All right? This nasty society, man. The shit that we were getting into, smoking cigarettes, smoking weed, man. Committing adultery, man. Now you look back at them acts and you think, fuck, I was doing that shit, man. Man, I must repent, man. And we repented of that, man. And now we fear the name of the Lord. So fuck you guys that want to lay hands on us, man. Fuck you scoffers and you scorners. We're going to glorify the name of the Lord. Let me read Psalms 34 again, man. Psalms 34 and 3. Oh, magnify the Lord Yahweh with me. And let us exalt his name together. And that's what we're going to do, man. Till kingdom come, Lord willing, man. And that's all I got to say about that. So Lord willing, you are king, we're edified, man. Know what you're signing up for, man. Know what this is about. This ain't no joke. If thou come to serve thy Lord, prepare thy soul for temptation, man. Reasonable service. And with that, all praises to Yahweh, Bar Shem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone that gave us the name, man. From their elders on down. It's a beautiful thing that we're out there teaching this word, man. Waking up our people, man. The elect of our people. Fuck, because not all of Israel are of Israel, man. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.